All right. First round. I'll be on the play. And this looks like what is probably going to be a pretty typical opener for us, including a Naga Vitalist. We do need somewhere to put all this mana, but I think we've got enough high-end places to put the mana. I think. Suppose I get to play either of my three drops next turn anyway, so maybe I skip a turn to get Evolving Wilds down so that I can cartouche at some point here. I suppose it works both ways. Like, if I play the Vitalist and then get the color that I want, then I can tap it for that mana, even though the land's tapped. But if I get the color I don't want, then I can't, so I think I'd rather do it this way. So, I should get black. I mean, yes, we have white cards in here, and it's a little bit annoying, but I think I should get black. And I'm going to play the Trial of Strength, and the reason I'm playing it is because I think that it's more likely that my opponent has Essence Scatter than they have Sensor, given that Essence Scatter is a common, and Sensor is an uncommon. If they have Sensor, then they get to counter either thing. But if they have Essence Scatter, and I play Trial, then they might leave that mana unused. Now, it turns out they had a Cycler too, but you know, there's every chance that we just played around that effect, so that's pretty good. Okay. Vizier. Ooh, man, I was hoping we drew that. Wow, that's an absurd draw. All right. So, cartouche, kill this thing, hit you for 5, pick up Trial. Love this. I was just looking at the Cartouche of Ambition and thinking, man, I wish you were a Cartouche of Strength. Turns out, it kind of became one. Yes, I would like to fight. Have 6 value here and jam. All right, this is working. Ooh, the plot thickens. 8. Pitiless Vizier. What do I do with this? The cat's back again. Jeez, cat. Man, the cat is just all about drafting today. So let's see. If I go Cartouche of Ambition, target this thing, I end up with a 6-4 lifelink, and I'm facing down a Pitiless Vizier, which would be a 3-1. Not bad, not bad. I also could just replay the Trial of Strength. I also could just attack here. If my opponent trades, then they take 3 damage and they lose their Pitiless Vizier, and I don't have to worry about the whole cycling thing later on. So that's value. And then I could play a Watchful Naga and have that kind of have the way cleared. What other way am I actually getting through this Pitiless Vizier? Well, there's not that many. So yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and attack here. And let's see what my opponent does. I'm assuming that they just go for the block here. We knock them down to 12, go to 25. And then the question is, do I want to play Watchful Naga so I have the chance to draw a card next turn? Or do I want to play Trial of Strength so that I can play Cartouche of Ambition next turn, slam again, and maybe even get a blocker out of the way, at least enough to enable an attack? And then, of course, pick up the Trial again. Because if I don't pick up the Trial, like if I don't play, if I go Watchful Naga, go, and I go Cartouche of Ambition the next turn, then I lose the chance to rebuy the Trial, which is just unacceptable. So I think what I'm going to do is just run out the Trial again here. It's also just 2 more power. So if my opponent has a slow situation here, then I get to just slam them again for a bunch of damage. I know, cat. Yeah, that's slow. All right. They don't have anything to get back right now. It's a little risky, but I'm going to go for the cartouche play here.
They could bounce my beast token, which would be a blowout. It would suck. But yeah, they also are so far behind if they don't that this happens. So that's why I go for those plays occasionally, is just because the upside seems so high. I didn't see any flyers, but we saw two blue cards. It's not unlikely that they have a flyer. Like, I think I'd feel pretty comfortable doing something like this. Also, white ended up being, of course, our much more minor color, but this pushes us a little harder. All right, let's see how this goes. All right, cat, all right. Is this a keep? Yeah, I think it is. I can go get a forest with the Evolving Wilds. I do need to draw a land here, though, because I effectively got just two tap lands. Ooh. Don't hate that. I think I am going to go ahead and sacrifice the Evolving Wilds here. Sometimes I wait on it. If I don't think I'm going to play anything, but if I go get a forest here and just draw a land, I get to play Naga Vitalist, which is a pretty big deal. And even if this does make it slightly less likely that I actually draw a land. All right. Yeah, I'll do that. This puts me pretty close to being able to cast Decimator Beetle. Just next turn I play Canyon Slough. And then I'll probably play like the Trial or something like that. And then if I draw a land, I can play the Decimator Beetle. The Exemplar of Strength, of course, is going to get a little out of hand. Ooh, nice. Hooded Brawler or Trial? I'll go for Trial. This could get canceled pretty easily. And it looks like it is. Reduced, okay. Same difference. Go ahead. Yeah, land into Decimator Beetle is going to be pretty great. Also, if I draw Plains, it wouldn't be bad either. I can then cast Dusk, especially if my opponent plays something else big this turn. They may just, go for Rubble. Which is pretty good with an Exemplar of Strength out. It's not great. I think I would feel fine about it, but it's pretty good. Yeah, they went for Rubble. Rubble, no land. Interesting. We also have no land, unfortunately. So, attack. Leaving all their mana up, kind of annoying. So I'm gonna go for the Colossipede here. Because if this gets countered, I think I'm in a better shape the next turn if this does, and if it doesn't, I'm totally fine. Colossipede blocks the Exemplar of Strength, and I'm quite happy to have a 5/5 on the battlefield. So it's kind of a hedge. I don't think it's super important which one I play there. Hieroglyphic Illumination, so they're back in business. I'm also more likely to want to just block with this one and just draw out a combat trick of some sort. And now I'm really likely to draw block with it. In fact, I think I just will now. Sure, there's one counter, but whatever. It gets taken off by the beetle anyway, so I'm just going to cash it in for 4 life. Go for the beetle now. We keep missing land drops. But if we can get, you know, one hit in with a cartouched up this, this, or this, then we're in good shape. If our opponent plays something big, if they deal with this and play something big, we draw planes, we can dusk and be in good shape. Okay, Vizier, don't care. Scribe for hieroglyphic, that's pretty good. All right. Well, it's not a plains, but it's close. So I think killing this is important, which I can do. I can play cartouche, put a counter on it, attack with beetle, take a counter off of this, put a counter on this, it dies. They do have a double block, though. Let's see, four. No, no, they don't. Yeah, that just seems good to me. I don't want them to get back the hieroglyphic illumination. Like, they can grind us to death with that. Nice. Uh-oh, are they gonna steal my guy? No! They're lay claiming. Oh! The greatest of sandworms, okay. Should just attack with this, yeah, okay. Well, this is interesting. This is interesting. So I could just play Dusk to Dawn. It kills my Decimator Beetle, but it also kills both this and this, so it's a 2-for-2. And then I could play a Watchful Naga or a Hooded Brawler after that. That's pretty good. I also could just play Oncrop Champion and pass. And then my opponent doesn't have any good attacks, at least as the board sits. Could bluff an attack with the Beetle, put a counter on the Sandworm, and then see what they do. If they block, then I go, sure, untap Dusk. I'm going to lose my Beetle anyway in that scenario. I don't hate that line. If I hit, what do? That's the interesting part. If I hit, I go up to 17, so I'm probably fine. Yeah, I do think this is enough of an issue. I'm at 12. 11 is a lot, so. I'm assuming they still just block, but if I'm in my opponent's seat, it is kind of scary. Well, this doesn't change anything. Unless they go for a double block? Double block. Double block. Why would you do that? Just to make sure it dies? Okay, I'll kill this guy. So now I got to kill that thing for free, and all I have to worry about is the Sandworm? Maybe I just want to dump my hand here then. Because I'm at 17, like, I'm not as worried about this thing anymore. Can still dusk no problem, but I can kind of leverage my board a little bit more here before I do. Okay. Okay. All right. Let's just cash these in. I'm going to buy back the Watchful Naga, but I really want the card now anyway. Like, a land would be pretty good. All right. Assuming that this thing gets untapped, blocks this. And then if they have a cycler, they'll probably go for that. All right. And block here. And then cycle. Oh, that's pretty annoying. Oh, they didn't have a cycler. Oh, they just keep throwing away their guys. This is kind of weird. All right, well. Cast this. Worm down. And then cast the Quarry Hauler. And then right now I can play Dawn to get back the Watchful Naga if I want. Okay. I'm going to just shrink that guy down. That makes sense. All right, all right. Play a brawler. And I'm just going to pass. And next turn, probably just going to exert both of these and see what happens. See what our opponent does here, though. Nothing. Yeah, I'm just going to do that. Getting back two Watchful Nagas with our Dawn seems pretty good. I guess I should have attacked with the Quarry Hauler, though. If they block here, this thing gets through. Yeah, no, this is fine. Because this is the obvious block, and then Hoodie B gets through for five. Buy back the Nagas. Replay one. I'm just trying to grind here. You know, we've got greater sandworms in our deck too. And we've got Second Suns and a bunch of other good stuff. Interesting. So they're splashing for this guy. Spring. It's not a bad late game card. It's really not. I'll go for it. I would be happy to trade off Quarry Hauler for the Defiant Great Maw. He can't get through it anyway. Wow. Okay. What's going on here? Wow, they just didn't have anything. What a bizarre attack. That just opened up the attacks for my entire team here. Give me that card. Big bombs. Oh, yeah. That's what we wanted. The hell? What is even happening? He just unexerted my guy for me. Oh no. It was a misclick. And they drew a slither play. Oh man. That's brutal. That is a beating. This is like the mocking slither blade, you know. Now they're gonna flashback this, but gotta find something sweet there. Cause we got the win. Ancient carbs. Probably not enough. Yeah, they just lose their dubs. Right? Everybody here attacks. This thing gets through no matter what. Might as well exert. It's the last turn of the game anyway. Dead. These blocks don't get the job done. All right, we got the GG there. Well, the deck was a little bit of a mess. I mean, I've seen some Slither Blade decks be good, but they don't look like that. You know, they're more all in on it. Okay, well, let's head to the second round.